Well, we left off. I was talking about Rosetta. I ran out of time, so there's only so much time on this phone. I have a million videos. I save them, and every so often I just went and delete them all because they're on YouTube. And it got to 19 minutes, and I thought that I could get through the two-year-olds quicker. I wasn't paying attention. So I talked about Rosetta, and I talked about Matt Bax's filly, how good she looked. Scotty said that he qualified one in 55 of Linda Toscano's. There's a couple other fillies look great. So there's certainly no slouches. There never is. Well, there never is anywhere. But there certainly never is in New Jersey. So so Tim may be the one bringing Rosetta to the Meadowlands. That'll be up to Tim. I'll talk to him about it this week. But I have every intention of, you know, training her up real good on Tuesday, racing her Saturday. I'd like to see a mile 58 out of her at the Meadows. And then we'll see. Actually, that class might go on Thursday. And then we'll see how everything goes with Rosetta. She sits at the bar, sounding up, by the way. Were you there? They were saying she was a little bit lame in that leg, and Mike put her on Baitrill.
Oh, I did.
She sounded right up the next day, and then has been great for 3-4 days now. So when she's good, probably 2-3 weeks of the aqua treadmill, and then out to the field, focus on 2025. What Mike also did say was he was thoroughly pleased with how little arthritis actually had already formed in there. Which is very, very good. So great job by Dr. Brown and Dr. Katie, Mike, everybody, his entire staff for what appears to be salvaging this filly's racing career and keeping her around. A lot of thanks to them for sure. Southwind Idex, I got to get looking at him a little bit. He's such a big horse. If he's not going to be useful right away, I'm more apt to just turn him out. I know I could train him in 2-2 right now, but that's not going to win you a race anywhere. Right? 2-2 has to lead to more. There has to be more waiting. That can't be the end of the rainbow. That has to be the middle of the rainbow. So when it comes to Southwind Idex, I think there's talent there. Yes, he's lazy, but he's also a big giant. And is there an okay horse in there? Possibly. Him and a horse we're going to talk about in a minute. Actually, next, Speed of Sound. Horses, I like both of them. I love Speed of Sound. I like Southwind Idex. These are horses where you have to look at them and say, okay, what is best for the horse? What is best for us? And how do we make all this work? And when it comes to Southwind Idex and Speed of Sound, they're on the same trajectory. I might just kick them out in the field for a month and a half or so. I think Speed of Sound has got a very, very bright future, but very, very big horse. And so is Southwind Idex. And is it just that their body can't do any more right now? I don't think it's that they're not able, like they're just not talented. I think they're both very talented. But one can do more than the other right now. And neither, at this point, are going to win a race anywhere. So, what do we do with that information? I think we probably just turn both horses out and let them grow up. That's my 2 cents. My take. The Priest, I have every intention of qualifying in 59 or 2 minutes at the Meadows on Tuesday. He'll go over there. And I suspect he'll be shipped out to Ronnie Burke. Shortly thereafter, where he'll race in the two-year-old stake races. That's my plan, anyway. Trevino on green. Somebody said the other day, Anthony, why didn't you go with Trevino, and what's going on with Trevino? I've been upfront with everybody. I believe Trevino on green is going to end up in the field, right? Big, giant colt. He's forging. He's getting out of gear. I've already trained him in 2.5. I already know the horse can go, but 2.5 is not 57 of Chicago Hall today. When you train Chicago Hall in 57 with a death grip on him, 2.5 with Trevino on green really puts things into perspective, right? He's just not ready to go right now. He's a big horse, just needs some time. Again, we just talked about Speed of Sound. We just talked about Southwind Idex. Same type of thing here. There's nothing wrong with that. If they're going to be useful horses, which I have every belief that they will be. Wander Hill. This is a very timely update. When we talk about useful horses, I don't know if he's going to be useful, to be honest. I said to Amy, he's been in 2.6. Now, 2.6 by himself. Now, I will give him that. He has not been in a group of horses. Yeah.
I'm not going in the barn.
Well, you can do whatever you want, but I'm going in the barn.
It's a dumb blinker. It's actually arrow the other way.
I was just thinking that. Kind of is a dumb blinker. Wander Hill, I don't know. We're going to find out very, very soon what's up with Wander Hill. He may just not be good enough. I don't know, but we're going to find out. Westland Warrior certainly is a very, very talented horse. In fact, if Scotty and I talked for 40 minutes the other day about the horses, a decent portion of that was on Westland Warrior. I said, don't sleep on this colt. We all know how good Momento Mori is. We all know he's a killer. We all know he's a nice horse. But I told Scotty, Westland Warrior's no joke either. He's in his shadow. He's overshadowed right now. But he's no joke. And I can't wait to see these horses go on Monday, and this is one of them also. And What a Lady, What a Night, as I said, trained great the other day. Very, very happy with What a Lady, What a Night. What she's done, how she looks, how she's coming. Probably go a mile in 2.7, 2.8 with her this week. She'll be ready exactly when we said she would, which is mid-February. And then Woodmere Betcha, her that hole in her tendon, it is healing. Is it healing fast enough? I don't know. I know she was ultrasounded the other day, and Jamie Smith continues to jog her. And if the vet says drive forward, then we're going to drive forward. But that will be up to the vet. And this is not a red light, green light situation. This will be a lot of yellow lights that hopefully will turn into a green light. And when that green light comes, I can't tell you. I don't know. I don't think even the vet knows. If you really force the vet, any of the vets that have looked at her, I don't think anybody can say unequivocally she will be ready in X on this date, at this time. All they say is she's not ready yet. So we'll continue to jog her, monitor that, keep an eye on it, and when she's ready, you will be the first to know. You'll be the second or third to know. But you will know right away. So, with that, those are all your two-year-olds. Sorry about the video. That was my fault. We'll be back probably tomorrow. I might do your three-year-old video tonight because they never take really that long. But I want to talk about the racehorses tomorrow. I want to talk about the opening tomorrow because we have some horses racing tonight. So, with that, I will talk to you all very soon. Have a wonderful rest of your evening. Raining, a little overcast, but you know what? For the heat we had all, I burnt my forehead today. Right there. Burnt my forehead today. I'll wear a hat tomorrow. Take care.